relational storage engines. So instead of storing all that structured data in HDFS, which is a flat file system, it's not indexed, there's sort of performance disadvantages to that, we've put that into a relational storage engine. And that allows us to get that significant performance boost.
Any reason for the relational view versus a graph view to build these layers?
Yeah, I mean, I think from the standpoint of doing traditional data warehousing analytics today, a relational database is perhaps the best. But we actually do have some interesting research into that as well that I guess we haven't talked about yet. It's out of Dan's yeah, right.
Can you talk about your business model a little bit and your target market?
Sure. So the business model, well, the pricing model, we're still figuring out. I'll be honest with you about that. The business model is to sell this as...
Then I'll take 10.
What's that? Yeah.
Then I'll take 10.
So the business model is this is proprietary software. It works with any Hadoop distribution. We're selling it on a annual subscription license basis that includes support bundled with it.
You have to be a champion for Hadoop, though, in this, and there's other choices for big data. So
yeah.
Want to speak to that a little bit?
Sure, absolutely. So you know, I think the key here is that people are moving to Hadoop for a couple of reasons. First of all, it's a really scalable system, both in terms of running on inexpensive commodity hardware rather than proprietary appliances. Also runs really well in the cloud computing environment, where you end up with these fluctuations in performance, and trying to put a typical parallel database in the cloud, you end up running as slow as the slowest node when one node slows down. So we think that more people are moving to Hadoop, and that's kind of a good thing for all of us in the ecosystem. And if we can help bridge that gap between the technical audience that's doing unstructured data analytics and combine that with the larger traditional data warehousing types of activities, we think that's an interesting opportunity.
We have plenty of time for more questions, Jeff.
So just to my question, I'm still a bit... So again, to my primary question, I'm still a little bit puzzled.
Here's mine.
<He's
so strong.
laughs> Well, people moved to Hadoop because it's cheaper, you know, HDFS because it's cheaper, and then, right. Yeah, we know that there is a performance hit and there's some other hits, but so now you're taking the same data and you move it back to SQL, which the reason they moved away from SQL is SQL doesn't scale. So did you build a brand new database, SQL database that actually scales and just provide an Hive interface?
Sure. Yeah, good question. So we've actually addressed the scalability issue by using Hadoop. So MapReduce is actually what's used to parallelize these queries. And that means that we can scale as well as Hadoop can scale to thousands of machines and petabytes of data. So the relational database, we're not actually building a traditional parallel database in the sense of starting with Postgres and coming up with a new system for doing that the way, you know, Aster or Greenplum or Vertica or ParXL have done. We're actually taking single node databases and parallelizing them using MapReduce, using Hadoop.
Who do you see as major competitors or threats to your business survival in terms of the incumbents?
I think certainly the data warehousing giants are certainly looking into the space. They talk more and more about the importance of Hadoop, and a lot of them have Hadoop connectors, which allow you to have a Hadoop cluster and a data warehouse and push data back and forth. You might use Hadoop for some ETL and cleaning up the data, and then you push it into your data warehouse. And I guess what we're arguing is you can do that all in one system.
So how defensible is your business? I mean, what sort of intellectual property or other things that can't be simply copied?
Yeah. So if you believe in software patents, we've filed 4 software patents, so that's one aspect. The other is, I'd like to think that we're sort of at the front of the curve in terms of this innovation. Daniel Abadi and his research team have been spending a lot of time, in fact, over 2 years, really researching this idea and pushing that forward. So we think that we'll be continuously innovating ahead of the curve on this kind of system. Okay. Thanks.
Thank you very much. Just a couple of reminders. You should be taking some good notes here because